Okay's beer, a fucking really old craft beer. I'm joined by Jason Oliver of Devil's Backbone Brewing Company out in Virginia in the USA. They've come over here to do a Meet the Brewer event in the UK with JD Weatherspoons. Jason is the head brewer of Devil's Backbone. First of all, let's talk about Jason. Tell us a little bit about your brewing history, Jason.
Well, I've been brewing for 18 years professionally. Started at an English-style brew pub in Baltimore, Maryland. And in fact, it was English equipment. Peter Austin Systems, the founder of the Ringwood Brewery, used to export his equipment worldwide. And so I started using the Ringwood yeast and open fermentation and English brew house. Since then, I went to brewing school, then came back to the Mid-Atlantic region where I grew up, which is around Baltimore. So most of my career is around Baltimore and D.C. And then about 6 years ago, I went down to Virginia to help open up Devil's Backbone.
Brilliant, brilliant. So in your former career before Devil's Backbone, what was your favorite style? What was the beer that you most liked brewing?
I think Best Bitter was probably my favorite beer.
Just really? That
it had a depth of character, but still a great drinkability to it.
Great, great. And then, of course, onto Devil's Backbone, where you now work, and head brew all of their beer. What was that like? You've obviously been through a great growth period with the brewery. The industry's going through a manic boom, which everybody involved is really pleased with. What's it like being involved with a brewery at the scale of Devil's Backbone?
Well, very much like this trip is a bit of a whirlwind. So our growth has been just very quick, very rapid. You know, we're 6 years old as a brand. Our production brewery is 3 years old, but we're exploding. I mean, already we're the largest brewery in our state. We've been blessed to receive all these accolades from the largest beer competitions in our country. And so we've had this rapid growth, and so it's been a wild ride. But what it has done, especially for me personally, it's given me an opportunity to grow more, because I've got these great opportunities to go traveling.
Yeah.
And, you know, explore different beers. I've talked to different brewers around the world. So before, I've pretty well traveled, but you know, in the last couple of years, you know, I've been to Australia, I've been to Europe, I've been to Germany, I've been to the UK several times. So you really learn a lot that way by just one-on-one conversations with other brewers.
Yeah, yeah. And my next question to you is the beers. What's your range, your core range of beers?
So our best-seller beer is our Vienna Lager. So it's an amber-hued lager beer with a nice caramel malt accent to it. Very smooth, very approachable, very sessionable. Comes in at about 4.9% ABV, which is sessionable for the U.S. standards for sure. But it really struck a chord, because this beer really is approachable for the craft man as well as just your normal drinker who might not think too much about their beer, but they know what they like. And so I like to say it gives you a lot, but it doesn't take from you, because it gives you this great depth of character. But it's at the same time, that beer isn't as challenging as some of our other beers. So it's not overly bitter, it's not overly sweet, it's not overly heavy. You know, it has color, it has complexity, it has depth of flavor, but it's not too much of any one thing. And but yet it gives you this great quality of flavor. And we do a lot of beer dinners with various restaurants, and that beer, it's amazing how well it goes with a variety of different foods. And so at any beer dinner, that's a no-brainer, include the Devil's Backbone Vienna Lager. So it's a very diverse beer that's just really found and rich in Virginia.
You seem to be, from what I'm hearing, it all comes from balance. What you're saying, your beers come from balance. There's a balance between the malt, there's a balance between the yeast, there's a balance between the hops. Am I correct in saying that?
Sure, absolutely. Like, I think, you know, from my my early days of beer was very English focused. But then the first brewing job at the Wharf Rat, now it's the Peter Austin system. And then I started getting into some more Germanic beers, and so we're doing more German beers, which also has their own sense of balance. And so now, you know, we do a variety of both ales and lagers, and yeah, you know, drinkability is definitely key. Where, you know, I'm not here to reinvent the wheel. I'm not here to try to be the first to do something.
Yeah.
I'm just here to brew the best beer I can brew.
Yeah.
And actually brew the beers in a selfish way, the way I want to brew them, the way I want to drink them. And so, you know, I'm a little selfish like that, but I really like drinkability.
And have a good time doing it.
Yeah.
A good time doing it. So, we were talking earlier, well, we've been speaking over a few beers here, the Devil's Backbone IPA. You're going through a good growth period as well. You're going up to 90 barrels? 90?
Our new brew house is coming. It's going to be a 120 barrel system.
120 barrel system. From what, from where was that 5 years ago?
Five years ago, it would have been a 10 hectoliter, 8.5 barrel system.
8.5 barrel system just 5 years ago, now to 120. That just, I'm not a mathematician, but that just shows me that there's an amazing kind of appeal and people want to drink your beer, and the boom in the craft beer industry is great, absolutely great.
That's amazing how many brewers are popping up and continue. It's been a really just huge growth spurt. And in Virginia, I think, you know, we're probably going on 70 plus breweries right now.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, it might not sound good to you, but just, you know, maybe 4 years ago, there might have been under 30. So just in 4 years time, it's almost doubled.
Double.
So it's, and that's the country as a whole too. Just an amazing amount of breweries in the United States now.
I read a lot. Me personally, I've got a great interest in beer, obviously, otherwise I wouldn't be recording this channel. But my interest is that I kind of sometimes Google craft beer. Whenever I Google craft beer, it's always about the growth of craft beer, the amount of new breweries that are opening in America. And I think it's a great thing. Now to the point where you've come over to the UK, you've collaborated with JD Wetherspoons, probably the largest chain of pubs in the UK, where there's a great chance to have a great meal at a great price and drink a great beer at a great price. Because I think where I'm going with this next part of the interview is, we still live in this little age of austerity, and there's got to be a balance between a high-priced beer. Like where we live in Cardiff, there's still a lot of people. We have a place called Mill Lane, where they eat nice dinners, and they think they're drinking nice beer. They're drinking Peroni at £4.50 a pint for a pint of Peroni. That's an incredible amount for a beer. This beer we have here, the Devil's Backbone, I think it's
$1.99,
and it's so much tastier. It's got so much more ingredients, got so much more flavour, so much more depth. Leave the Peroni alone, leave the kind of mass-produced swill alone, and try something decent. I think that's the message. But how did it come about?
Well, I've been over here three previous times doing cask ales for the Wetherspoon Group as an invitational brewery. And they've been bringing over international brewers for years from all around the world, but a lot from the USA as well. And so I've brewed an American Amber Ale, I've brewed an American IPA, I've brewed a Pale Ale. And so this sort of developed out of my last brew, which was a Pale Ale called Independence Ale, which was brewed and to be put on tap around our 4th of July holiday at all the Wetherspoon pubs.
Right.
And so what I wanted to do with that pale ale was blend both English hops and American hops, because, you know, of our close relationship as countries, where, you know, we develop out of the UK.
Yeah.
And so this IPA, the DB Devil's Backbone American IPA, has both English and American hops. And so that's where it's sort of like the beer came out of. Now, the idea to do this was always kind of bounced around since I've been involved in that, in the invitational brews, and all of a sudden it kind of came to a head. It's like, the time is ripe, let's do it. and we were up for the challenge. And you know, it's something that I love coming over here, doing these beers, and we're coming over here again in February to do the next international showcase. We brew in a Session Chef Black IPA, so that should be fun. So it kind of evolved in my participation in brewing the Cascales here.
Yeah.
And they wanted a year-round product, you know, teaming up with American brewers to be brewed in the UK, so you have freshness. You know, it's kind of funny, since I came over here the first time, 2.5 years ago, you know, I saw there's a lot of American craft brews in some of the pubs and some of the markets, and, you know, I had an opportunity to taste some, and some of them were tasting a little tired to me, and it kind of took me back to when I was getting my feet wet, and I was buying the English brews and the German brews and the Belgian brews, and some of them were great, but some of them were tired too. But that was my first kind of foray. So I think this is great because hopefully some people's first taste of sort of American craft beer is going to be fresh. So that's pretty cool.
Absolutely fresh. Talking about the freshness, we'll do a miniature beer review for you live on the channel. What do you think of the beer here in the UK?
I think the color is great, sort of a deep burnished gold color. Great mouthfeel, does not sit heavy on the palate, has a nice creamy palate. Definitely has carbonation, but there's not a prick to it, so there's not a sting to it. Nice lasting head, nice lasting lace into it. Nice dry hop character, it has that sort of subtle earthiness and minerality of the English hops, but then it has also some of the citrus notes from the American hops too.
It's, for me, drinking this beer while Jason was talking, it's like a battle in your mouth between British yeast, British malt, and American hops. One big battle in the mouth. And it works, it really does work. You can almost kind of try and close out them American hops. If you can do that and drink this as a kind of a yeasty British malty beer, but then you could switch on right at the back end of the palate and it could be an American IPA also. It's just got that great balance between the two countries, really.
I think that's a great dynamic to this, great dynamic beer, but at the same time, it's not loud or obnoxious. Mm. It has depth. It does have a change, as it warms up, it changes. It goes through an evolution of smells and flavors. It's a really interesting beer. I tell you what, I'm really happy with it. And, you know, it's what I call infinitely drinkable, you know what I mean? And that beer should be. Sometimes I think craft brewers try to challenge people too much. They're challenging themselves and they challenge the public where, you know, it's all about enjoyment and enjoying a beer and having a couple pints with your friends. And, you know, you don't always have to be challenged to be rewarded. And I think it's a very rewarding beer.
Absolutely, absolutely. One last question before we go. What's the future, Devil's Backbone?
Future, hopefully, continue our growth, continue the ability to brew the beers we want to brew, and have fun with it.
Yeah.
You know, it's what's been great about our company is that no one's ever told me what beers to make. And so I made probably over 150 different recipes so far, ranging the gamut of just all the, say, the, I hate to use the word traditional, but traditional brewing culture of the world, and then also very eclectic stuff as well. And, you know, we pick the ones we want to scale up and to put into production. And so, no, not once have I ever been told, oh, you gotta make this, you gotta do this. You know, we make what we wanna make, and, you know, if it has legs, if people like it, well, then maybe we'll put it in a bottle, maybe we'll scale it up. But it comes from within, it comes from a very organic place.
Yeah.
And so I hope the future maintains that.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, the future is bright. So.
Jason Oliver, thank you for the interview.
Cheers.
Thank you for joining me. Devil's Backbone, check it out. It's an IPA, all Weatherspoons in the UK. Cheers.
Cheers.